If you have a whole life insurance policy, instead of swiping your credit card, use your policy instead to cover unexpected expenses. My name is Darius.
And I'm Carmen.
For the best infinite banking financial advice, subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell to be notified when we post new videos.
50% of Americans have to go into debt for expenses larger than $500. So what we've been taught is to have an emergency fund, which is about $1,000 or so, so that you can cover those unexpected expenses. So if you have been watching our channel, you know that Darius and I do things a little bit differently. And in this case, instead of putting our money in the bank, we actually put our money inside a whole life insurance policy so that at the bare minimum, our deposits, the money that we work so hard for, can earn 4% instead of the 0.1% that the banks are paying. So by the end of this video, you will learn how you can use a whole life insurance policy to cover your unexpected expenses.
When life hands us lemons, we make lemonade because we tell our money where to go instead of it telling us where it went. So we have multiple policies to make sure we cover our assets in case of emergency. So let's say, for example, you have an unexpected car repair and it costs you, let's say, $3,000. So instead of swiping your credit card, you're going to use your whole life insurance policy instead, because most Americans, like we said, 50% of Americans can't handle an emergency over $500 without going into debt. So we're going to piggyback off that. We're going to use our whole life insurance policy instead of using a credit card.
Because what happens when we swipe our credit card is now every single month we have to pay principal and interest back to the bank in order to cover those car repairs. So comment below with been there, done that, if you have experienced a similar circumstance. And also check out our video here, good debt versus bad debt, so that you can understand the difference between debt and how it functions.
The reason why we bring this up is because life always happens. And when you don't have a plan, you're always running behind your money. And what plans do is they give you confidence for when things do come up that you can handle it.
Yeah.
That's why when gurus like Dave Ramsey say to put $1,000 in your emergency fund, we take that money and we put it inside of our policy so that we can earn 4% mm-hmm. instead of the 0.1% that we get inside of a typical savings account.
Exactly.
But things do change. These days, $1,000 covers less and less. That's why we raised the ante just a little bit to $5,000, because by having $5,000 inside your emergency fund, you're able to be a little more comfortable when things do happen.
So when unexpected expenses come up, you borrow from your whole life insurance policy using that cash value to fund those purchases. And then you do rule number two and rule number three, which is pay yourself interest and then recapture, meaning get all of that money back so that you have that money again to reuse for the next unexpected expense. Because just like a credit card, every time you swipe that credit card, you have to pay principal and interest back every single month until the credit card is paid off. So we want you to treat yourself the exact same way you would a credit card. But the difference is that you get to keep all of that money for yourself to reuse instead of giving the bank back their money every single year. Because let's be honest, you're probably right now financing a car, financing your mortgage, and probably have a few credit cards. So don't you think you're giving enough money to the bank? So take your income and pay yourself back so you can keep more of your money instead of letting it leave your household.
So let's go ahead and debunk the objections. Objection number one, Carmen and Darius, there isn't enough money in the first year to cover my expenses. Well, if you have a $5,000 policy, then you will have $3,000 available to cover any expense that you have. And you have a death benefit in case you really have an emergency. But remember, you were just gonna save $1,000, but now you have $3,000 and you have a few hundred grand in death benefit. So let's face it, life isn't guaranteed to anyone. Matter of fact, half of you watching this may not even have life insurance. So why not kill two birds with one stone by having an emergency fund for emergencies and having life insurance to cover your family if anything was to happen to you?
Now, objection number two. Carmen and Darius, I have to pay $5,000 a year for this policy? Well, in this example, yes. Yes, you do. But let's break this down a little bit further, because when we're talking about paying yourself and saving for emergencies and providing for your family, if you can't pay $5,000 a year or wrap your head around that concept, then maybe we're not talking to you. Because out of the 261 working days that we have on an annual basis, you're basically telling yourself that you are not worth $19.15 a day for all of the work that you're doing. So you're okay with giving everyone else your money, but you're not okay with saving $20 a day for yourself because you're the one that's doing all the work. That's fine. Keep doing what you're doing.
Objection number 3. What do I do with all the extra money that I have that I didn't use? Well, you can save it, invest it, take your family on a vacation. It's up to you. You can even give it to us.
We'll find something to do with it. And objection number 4, Carmen and Darius, I have to wait 5 business days in order to access the cash value from my policy. And this is absolutely correct. However, if you know how to utilize something called a segregated account that Darius and I talk about, check out the video here also if you need to access that video. But you do have liquidity as long as you know how to move the money. So you don't have to wait those 5 business days in order to access the funds for your emergencies.
We may have been a little harsh today, but just remember, wealth isn't about how much money you make, it's about how much money you keep. And if you're able to keep more of your money inside your system and pay yourself back principal and interest, that's more money that you can save, invest, and accomplish your own goals. So now that you know how to cover your unexpected expenses, we've created a free guide called 52 Ways to Own Your Own Lifestyle Through Investing, Creating Your Own Banking System, and Paying Off Debt. So click the link below to get your free copy.
And also, if you want to join a community of like-minded high achievers just like yourself, check out our Patreon community where you can learn the ins and outs of the infinite banking concept. And everything that we talked about on this video today is in the Patreon community, except we just shown you the numbers so you know what it looks like if your car breaks down and you need the funds to pay it back and how much money you accumulate in your system year after year. So go ahead and click on the link below so that you can check out our Patreon community.
And if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe, and share it with a friend.
And don't forget to own your own lifestyle.
Or someone else will.